Hello, Tab Nation. It's your boy Tom, and today we're going to be talking about how to be a better Googler. I know that sounds like a funny phrase, but when you're a coder, being able to Google stuff is actually like a skill set. I actually have put that on my resume before because it's actually very important because if you can Google something, get exactly what you want faster, you're going to be able to code faster because, let's be honest, there's a good chance somebody's already done the code somewhere. So why should you sit there, write an entire library or whatever function when somebody's already done it and you can copy and paste it and tweak it to how you want? You know, so being able to Google stuff, it's actually important. A lot of people go to Google and just think, oh, sorry, my throat's a little dry today. People think you can just type in whatever and you're going to get the best results. Sure, the algorithm's nice and all, but a lot of people don't know that there's hidden features that make the algorithm a little bit more accurate so that you can tweak it a little bit better. So, you know, for example, let's say we're going to Google something. If you put it in quotations, you're actually going to get like exact results versus whatever. So as we see here, we're going to Google this. So cannot read properties of undefined. We want that in quotations, which it should have been already. There we go. And you're going to get exact matches. So cannot read properties of undefined. And, you know, we're going to get way better results. So putting stuff in quotations is just a much better thing to do. Another one we can do is, I got these listed on a notepad, just so I can copy and paste stuff a little faster, is you can actually search specific sites. So here we're going to say site, put the little commas here or whatever they're called. I always forget the clock things. freecodecamp.org react. So we can actually search for specific websites. So as you see, how to get started with React, freecodecamp.org, freecodecamp.org. Every result is only for that website. So that's a great thing to know also, is just how to do that. Now, another thing you can do is you can use a minus sign to eliminate certain words. So here we're going to do how to write components in React minus, no space is really needed, class. So we're going to search, and this is going to find results for that, but it's going to exclude anything that has the word class in it. So that's a way to also get very specific if you're getting results for React with class and you're like, no, that's not what I want. You can eliminate that. Maybe you're making a GUI or, you know, a web designing a website and you need a picture that's very specific to a size. So what we can do there is, let's say we're going to do funny cat. Yeah, we'll just go with funny cat, and we're going to type in, what is it? Image size. Put the little things there, and we're going to say 500 by 600. I spelled image wrong. Sorry, it's hard to see my keyboard when I have a mic in front of it. And this is going to find very specific pictures that are at 500 by 600. So that's a great way if you need a very specific size for your GUI or your website, you can do that. Another one is searching specifically for a file type. So we're going to do React JavaScript tutorial, and then we're going to do file type, once again those, and we're going to say PDF. And so we come down here, And these are all going to be sites where it has something to do with React JavaScript that contains a PDF on their website. So yeah. Doesn't look like we got very good results though for that. But that will help you find very specific file types. You can also do wildcards where you maybe want to don't know how you want to complete the phrase. This could be something where maybe you're not 100% sure what to Google. I use this one quite a lot. So we can do, like, the example here is going to be the. We're going to use the asterisk here. That's a wild card. Basically, use a word there. The blank of auto hotkey. And so this is just kind of using a wild card where it's going to find, it's going to fill in. Now, obviously, with this, we're going to get a ton of results because it could be like the send of AutoHotkey, the version of AutoHotkey. So you should probably get a little bit more specific here, but that wild card is going to give us a ton of results just because it's using a wild card. But yeah, that's so that you can... get it done. You know, here we go. This is probably a better example. The philosophy of money. The philosophy of money. The power of money. So as you see, it's just filling in a blank word to help you get better stuff. Another one we can do is we can use the and or logic. So we can say auto hot key. And then we're going to say and Python. And so that's, can Python do everything AutoHotKeys can do? AutoHotKey.Python. So it's like a library, probably. So yeah, it's going to basically search for both the word AutoHotKey and Python at the same time and give us, you know, whatever kind of results we're looking for. Filter out searches with after and before or dot dot if you're using numbers. So this is good for if you want to find something a little bit newer. So we could say Python after, and let's just go with 2020. Let's go with 2022. So we're going to search, and hey, look, there's some of Joe's videos. So these are obviously 1 week ago, 2 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago. So that's going to give us results on anything that's newer. And it can be a little good and bad sometimes. So 2023, 2023, 2023, 2023. For some reason, it did kind of do this with 2015. But that's probably because this is a community page and people are still posting on it. So even though it was created in 2015, there's still newer content on it. Just because of people making responses still, even in this state. So yeah, that kind of can help you get newer articles if you're doing research especially. You can also find related searches. So AutoHotKey, we can do, let's say, related. And we're just doing related to AutoHotKey. And obviously we're going to get a lot of results for that. So, you know, alternative applications most similar to AutoHotKey, other languages like AutoHotKey or AutoIt. So it's just going to find stuff that might be related in some way to AutoHotKey. So here it's basically finding stuff that will find us other languages if AutoHotKey's not cutting it for us. So yeah. But yeah. Hopefully you guys found this very interesting. I'm sure there's lots more that I didn't cover in that video. So in the comments below, let me know some other tips and tricks that you all have on how to use Google in a more efficient way. Or if you want to expand on the examples I gave in here in some way, definitely let me know in the comments below so it helps the other people. And I will see you all on the next one. Bye.